We are looking at class 12th mathematics sample paper for board exam. Section C, 4 marks each. First is, there are two parts. So, you can, two options actually. So, A plus B plus C is pi. You have to find the value of this. See, A plus B plus C equal to pi. You should know what is sine A plus B sine pi. You should know what is, because here you can write A plus B is equal to pi minus C. What is cos pi minus C? So, A plus B plus C plus pi, we can just replace here pi. Sine pi is 0. We can write A plus B is equal to pi minus C. We can replace here. And this will be cos minus cos C. And now, with this equation, or with this determinant, we can open it with any of these column or row. So, we are opening it with the first row, and when you solve it, you get these two, and this gets cancelled, it will be 0. The next is, you have to show, first of all, let me show you the question. You have to show that this determinant is equal to this. So, first of all, if we add this column with this column, we get A plus B plus C. We can take A plus B plus C outside. So first of all, what we'll do, we'll change in this column 1 with column 1 plus column 3. So, you get A plus B plus C, you take it out, you get 1, 1, 1 here. Now, you change with R2, in R2, R2 minus R1. You change in R3, R3 minus R1. You get this value, you solve it and multiply with A plus B plus C, you'll get the desired result. It is given that for function this, Rolle theorem holds in 1 comma 3 with C as 2 plus 1 by root 3. You have to find the value of A and B. So, see, the Rolle's theorem holds true, that means F1 will be equal to F3. So, just place 1 here and then 2, then 3 here and equate. When you equate, you get the value of A. Then Fx is this, so find out the F dash x, that is the derivative of this, you get this. Just replace 11 with A. So, this is your final F dash x. You know that F dash c equal to 0. Just place this C, because it is already given, C is there. So, F dash C equal to 0, place this C value here, and you see that it is independent of B, because B is binary. Determine for what values of x, the function x cube plus 1 by x cube is strictly increasing or decreasing. There is one more option, we'll see in a bit. F dash x is x cube plus 1 by x cube, this fx. So, f dash x you can find out, the derivative. You can write it like this. This is nothing but 3 into x to the power 6 minus 1 by x to the power 4. X to the power 6 minus 1 to the power 6. We can use the formula x cube of 2 minus 1 cube of 2, a square minus b square, and you can again solve it. So, you get this equation, or this solution basically. Now, this cannot be negative. See, x to the power 4, x to the power 2, x to the power 4, this is constant, this is constant. It cannot be negative. We will talk about x plus 1 and x minus 1. So, the critical point, if we take x plus 1, x is equal to minus 1, and for this x minus 1 equal to, x equal to 1 here, minus 1 here. So, minus 1 and 1, these are the critical points. So, the f dash x, if it is greater than 0, then x should be not lying between 1 and minus 1. But if f dash x is less than 0, it is less than 0, then x must lie between 1 and 1. So, fx is strictly increasing if this is the case, and strictly decreasing if this is the case. Now, the next one, the equation is like this. Y is equal to x cube minus 11x plus 5. The point on the curve this, at which the tangent is this. Tangent, and this is the curve. So, what will we do here? This is the equation, so we will find out the dy by dx. So, this equation will become x cube minus 11x plus 5 will become 3x square minus 11 if we differentiate it. So, the slope of the tangent is, because the slope of the of the line is given to us. What is the line? Line is y equal to x minus 11. Y is equal to x minus 11. So if you equate with m, y is equal to mx plus c, m is 1. The slope is 1. The slope is 1. So this is the slope, equate it with 1. And just solve it, you get x is equal to plus minus 2. For x equal to 2, you get y equal to minus 9. For x equal to minus 2, you get y equal to minus 13. So these are the points you get. But if you place this or keep this in the curve, you are going to get the result not with this. So this is going to give the equation will be satisfied. So this is your required point. You have to evaluate from 0 to 2 x square plus 3 dx as limits of sum. In this, fx is x square plus 3, a is 0 and b is 2. And what is nh? This is b minus a. So 2 minus 0 is 2. And we know that limit of sum is given by limit h tends to 0. H fa plus fa plus h plus fa plus 2h plus fa n minus 1 into h. Right? So let us start with fa. That is f 0, a 0, x square plus 3, that is 3. You get 3 here. Now, again place f a plus h. I'm going to tell you 1 or 2. You will be able to take all these. So, f, now a plus h. A is a 0. So, fh. Fh is what? H cube plus 3. H square plus 3. This is the second one. Likewise, you can get the other values. But here we see 3, 3, 3, these are repeating n times. So you can write 3n here. For others, this one, you can take h square common and you get this equation. We know that the sum of the first n natural number or square of a natural number is nothing but n plus 1, 2n plus 1 by 6. This you get, right? Now you have n minus 1 here. So place n minus 1 here, n minus 1. You get n minus 1, n to n minus 1 by 6. So this is the, you can say the solution of this. H cube is there because we have multiplied h with inside and h inside, h cube. Now multiply each h inside, n minus 1 h, nh, 2 nh minus h. Okay. Now we'll employ the value of nh, that is 2. So 2 minus h, this is 2, this is 2 into 2, 4. This 3 into nh, nh is 2, so you get this value. And since limit h tends to 0, put this h as 0, you get 26 by 3. Find the area of the region bounded by the y-axis, y equal to cos x and y equal to sin x. The range is 0 to pi by 2 of x. First of all, you must know the curve of cos x and sin x. This would be something like this. We are just making till 0 to pi by 2 because the range is given. So this is your sine, this is your cos. So with this equation, we have to find this value, this shaded portion. And what is this shaded portion? See, sine pi by 2, pi by 4 and cos pi by 4, they give you same value. This is the value. Sin 45 and cos 45, they both are 1 by root 2. So here we get an intersection point. So we have to find this area. For this, we'll find out this area total, which will be nothing but 0 to pi by 4 cos x, and this area. This is 0 to pi by 4 sin x. We will subtract these two, we'll get this area. So this is 0 to pi by 4 cos x, 0 to pi by 4 sin x. And you can integrate it, sin x plus cos x, 0 to pi by 4, you apply the limit and you get root 2 minus 1. We have two options here. We'll start with this. Y is equal to ax plus b by a. Can this be a solution of this differential equation? If no, then find the solution of this differential equation. So, y is equal to ax plus b by a. When you take the derivative of this, you get dy by dx is a. This will be no more there and this x will be eliminated. So you will get dy by dx equal to a. Now, just substitute the value of a, value of a in this one. What you get? dy by dx, you get this. So you are getting the differential equation. So this is actually the solution of this differential equation. The second is, check whether these differential equation is homogeneous or not, and find the general solution of the differential equation using substitution y equal to vx. So this is the differential equation for you. We are just taking the same one and we are trying to rearrange it. So when we rearrange, we found that dy by dx is 1 plus xy plus cos y by x, x square, which is nothing but we take these two together. So this is y by x and this plus this by x square. So 1 plus cos y by x by x square. 1 plus, if you multiply, this is your equation fxy. How to check the homogeneity? If this is fxy, so to check the homogeneity, just take or put lambda x in place of x and lambda y in place of y and try to solve it. This gets cancelled, this gets cancelled, but here you will left with lambda square. So lambda is there, so it is not equal to fxy, therefore this differential equation is not a homogeneous equation. Now let us solve it. We have to put y equal to vx, dy by dx will be v plus x dv by dx. So this dv, v plus dx dv by dx will be equal to v plus, because we have taken y by x as v, 1 plus cos v by x square. This gets cancelled. Now take dv terms together, x terms together. So this is the dv term, v terms, and these are the x terms. Now 1 plus cos theta is equal to 2 cos square theta by 2. We use here. This is 2 cos square theta by 2, that is v by 2, and when you take it up or take it to the numerator, it will be 6 square v by 2 dv. And this is 2 by x cube dx. Now just integrate both the sides. Sec you get 10 and this you get minus 1 by x square. This is your solution. If the vectors p, q and r, they are coplanar, then find, then for a, b, c, which is not equal to 1, it cannot be 1, you have to show this exist. Since the vector PQR, they are coplanar, so PQR equal to 0, that means we will write the value of PQR. P is A11, Q is 1B1 and R is 11C. We place it here with the determinant equal to 0. And we try to solve it. R2 will change as R2 minus R1. R3 we will change as R3 minus R1, so that we can get 1 or 2 zeros. Now let us solve it. When we solve it, you get some equation like this. And just divide all by 1a, 1 minus a, 1 minus b, 1 minus c. You get this kind of equation. For a, 1 minus a by 1 minus a, we can write it 1 minus a. This is equal to 1 minus a minus 1 by 1 minus a. That is minus a by 1 minus a. So we place the minus also. Now take 1 here, you get this equation. A plane meets the coordinate axis in ABC such that the centroid of triangle ABC is the point alpha beta gamma. Centroid is given. You have to show that the equation of the plane is this. Since you know that the equation of a plane which is having the intercept A, B and C on three coordinate axes is nothing but x by A, y by B, z by C. And we have a triangle with point as A00, 0B0 and 00C. What is the centroid? A plus 0 plus 0 by 3, B plus 0 plus 0 by 3 and C plus 0 plus 0 by 3. A by 3, B by 3, C by 3. And when you equate these three with the given values alpha, beta, gamma, you get A equal to 3 alpha, B equal to 3 beta and C equal to 3 gamma. You now know the value of A, B and C. Place it in this equation, you get this equation, take 3 here. This is the final equation. A 20-year-old old girl drives her car at 25 km per hour. She has to spend 4 km on petrol. If she drives her car at 40 km an hour, the petrol cost increases to rupees 5 km. She has rupees 200 to spend on petrol and wishes to find the maximum distance she can travel within 1 hour. Express this problem as linear programming problem. And also write any value reflected in the problem. The value is that always whenever you go outside, keep your tank full and keep some money with you. So let us express this as a linear problem. See, just assume that the distance covered with speed of 25 km is x and the limitation is 200. And the distance covered by 40 km an hour is y km. Total distance let us assume as z. So z will be equal to x plus y. And the constraint is when you are taking 4 km per, this is the amount. So 4 into x, this distance, plus 5 into this y will be, should be less than equal to 200 because only 200 rupees she has. So let us divide it by 200, x by 25, y by 40 less than equal to 1. And of course, x should be greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0. So this is the linear programming problem. The random variable x has the probability distribution of this form. Px is k for x equal to 0, 2k for x equal to 1, 3k is equal to x equal to 2. We have to find the value of k first of all. So we know that the sum of probability is 1. So k plus 2k plus 3k will be equal to 1. We get 6k equal to 1. So k is nothing but 1 by 6. You can place it here. Find x, px less than 2. So less than 2 is 0 and 1. Less than equal to 2, so you get 2, 1, 0. And x greater than equal to 2, so you get this only. So x and px can be written like this. We know that this addition of the probability is always 1, all the probabilities of a given event. So you add this, you get k equal to 1 by 6. For x less than 2, you get 1 and 0. So p0 plus p1, that is k plus 2k, which is equal to 3k, k you can take as 1 by 6. Px less than equal to 2, p0 plus 1 plus 2, less than equal to 2. So k plus 2k plus 6 is 6 into 1 by 6, that is 1. And greater than equal to 2, this only will comply. So p2, that is 3 into k, that is 3 into 1 by 6, so it will be half. A bag contains 2n plus 1 coins. It is known that n of these coins have a head on both sides. Both of its sides, whereas the rest of the coin are fair. So 2n plus 1 total coin, n are not fair coin, unfair coins, and 2n plus 1 minus n, that is n plus 1, these are fair coins. A coin is picked up at random from the bag and is tossed. If the probability that the total result in a head is this, find the value of n. So we'll find out the probability of head for fair coin and unfair coin, and then we will add them and will equate to 31 by 42. So let us assume that this event E1 is a coin having head on both sides, so unfair. E2 is a fair coin which is selected, and the event is A, head comes up in tossing a selected coin, which is given 31 by 42. So PE1 is nothing but n. This is n are the fair coin. Total is 2n plus 1. So n by 2n plus 1. Probability of E2 is nothing but you have n plus 1 fair coin, so n plus 1 by 2n plus 1. And the probability of head coming up when an unfair coin is used is always 1, because every time head will come. And the probability of getting head when the fair coin is selected is half, because head can come and tail can come, they have equal probability, that is half. Now we know that P1, P2, PA1, PA2, will directly apply it to the formula. So we know that PA final is 31 by 42. So PE1 into PA by E1 plus PE2 into PA by E2 is 31 by 42. What value we have found out, we will place it here and n will be 10. So this is the section C of sample paper of 12th board mathematics. Thank you so much.